Wah, wah, wah.
Welcome, everybody. Welcome to the Bone Pit. I'm your host, BoneSkore, and today I am tired as shit. Today we are playing Odin Sphere, Leifthrasir, and we are playing the Pooka Prince, Cornelius. I'm exhausted. Skye's here, says, "Aw, poor baby. I don't know if you're being sarcastic or if you are genuine with that, but either way, I'm just going to say thank you." Too tired to put up a fight. Welcome, buddy. Welcome. How are you? Hope you're doing well today. Hope all is good with you. I was up till fucking like 3 o'clock last night trying to unzip a fucking ROM. Seven zip is just awful. Seven zip is like an awful program. It was fine. It was totally fine until I started trying to unzip stuff that was like bigger than like a couple hundred megabytes. And that shit started to go downhill real fast. And then my laptop started doing shit, and So I've been tinkering with that all day in my stupor, trying to get it to unzip faster and work better or whatever, right? This guy says, "I saw your Twitter post. What size was the file that was taking 8 hours? This guy says, "Holy shit, you must have the 1997 version." Yeah, it's quite possible. It's possible that my programs need to be updated a little bit. I just click download, and I don't know if they've been updated or not. That would be a good thing to check, though, just in case, before I go ahead with it next time. But I think like half of them done. I got like half the ROMs dealt with. The rest of them, though, get significantly bigger from one to the next. So like one starts at like 500 megabytes and then goes up to 6 and then 7, and then we're going up by gigs up to like 3 gigs. So that last one, the ones that are closer to like 3 gigs are probably going to have to be like I'll get up and I'll start them in the morning and they'll just go like all day. So that'll be fun. Firefox says, "Just use your hands to unzip it. Jeez, it's not that hard." We're talking about jeans, right? That's right, buddy. That's right. I'm talking about my digital jeans. I should just be able to click and drag with the zip. You're right. You're right. That would make things a lot easier. If you could just zip, and there's the file. Alas and alack, here we are today. So let's dive in and do us an Odin Sphere. Why not? Shall we? Why not? I don't think there's anything to announce / bitch about. Just mention the Discord real quick, which is there behind the sub button, along with emotes and badges. It's a cool place. I'm there. Check it out. And that's the pitch. Moving past that, I'm going to get up, turn the TV on, and we'll play a game. All right, how's that sound? Does that sound good to everybody? Is that good? Is that good? Does that sound good to everybody? All right, it doesn't matter. I'm getting up now. Wah. Wah, 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 wah. Bam, there we go. This guy says, "Instead, your hand takes hours to pull the zipper down." That's, yeah. Yeah, it's like your hand touches the zipper, and then it goes into, like, stasis. Paralyzing zipper. It's the worst. You can't get it out when you need to most. Oh. Yeah, fucking, I spent, like, all morning, on forums, checking Google, searching different things, and trying to figure out, is there a way to...
Oh!
Manus2k6 is here. Welcome. Welcome, how are you? Hope all is well today. Hope you are doing good. I mean, BoneSkore. Yes, welcome. hope things are good in your neighborhood. Hope things are good in everybody's neighborhoods, as always. There he is. Yeah, I spent all morning trying to like figure out like if I can make the programs faster. If I can make them. Like, if there's something in my system I could change, whatever, right? And almost all of the threads that I checked were the exact same. And it was just people asking, how are you unzipping it? What program are you using? What are your system specs? And then no help. People just asking for like the specifics of the scenario and then not offering any more input. Has been spending time in the bad part of town.
It's as if he's a new man. People have seen me? That's ludicrous.
They've seen me? I have a doppelganger walking around, huh? Firefox says, just ask Reddit about it. I would. Except I am not on Reddit. I used to be on Reddit, and there was this really shitty thing involved where it was like, no matter where I went, there was this fucking stupid thing where it was like, hey, you need to build up karma or whatever before you can post stuff here. You need to, like, I don't know. Like, get recognized in the system or some shit. And the only way to do that, as far as I know, is, like, to make posts to different boards and stuff, which it wasn't gonna let me do. I don't know. I couldn't let Reddit to actually let me post anything. So... I don't know. Maybe I'm just turning into a dinosaur. But, yeah. I'm not on Reddit. Also, from what I saw from Reddit, it's, like, generally a huge, like, a very toxic place, so I don't particularly want to go back on there. The help threads are great, right? Like, the technical threads, where when you have, like, shit wrong with your computer and stuff, those are excellent. People are always helpful in the Reddit threads, but, like... Just, like, outside of that, like, unless you're in, like, a tech forum and you're asking, like, for help with a specific problem, Reddit seems to be a very toxic place. Almost more so than Twitter. Nabooka Prince, Chapter 3, Act 2!
I managed to sneak in, but how will I be able to speak with my father?
There was no, like... other so doorway coming. In the city there to get to the Pooka village, huh? I don't think so. I don't imagine
that little fiend.
I can. Oh man, it's a doppelganger.
That's me.
Guess well, every place I've worked has had IT teams with the same attitude with helping people with computer issues.
Otherwise, oh man, deceive the prince for nothing. It's. So he's behind all this.
I shall cut him down.
I felt awful.
Here you are, Cornelius.
Cause like,
have you reached?
It kept like freezing, and hanging at certain points. Like, I'd wait several hours, and then it would just stop.
What?
It would stop extracting at, like, 75% or whatever. And then I'd try to close it down, and it would actually just, like, freeze and crash the computer. So I'd have to hard reset, and doing so also buggered up my USB, which then had to be repaired every time.
I would like to ask you something in return.
I've only managed to do, like, one or two zips at a time.
The royal family's secret power.
And then it has to be, like, shut down, restarted.
Go on, leave. Stop wasting time.
But I felt marginally better, because as I was taking to Twitter, trying to find help,
Now, how did he find out?
Somebody that I follow on Twitter, a more famous name you guys might have heard, you might know, Super Eyepatch Wolf.
Please listen
to me. He's also having computer troubles lately, and his thread about his journal in about buying a Dell computer is simultaneously one of the funniest things I've ever read, and also one of the most heart-wrenching, despair-inducing stories, because it's like exactly the kind of thing I was afraid of when I was building my PC.
Father, you must believe me.
But, like, reading about the trouble that Eyepatch Wolf is going through right now with his computer made me feel infinitely better about what's going on with mine and gave me the courage to power through it.
It was given to me. A terrifying voice.
It made me realize, holy shit, I kind of know a thing or two about computers, I guess.
That blood-smeared sword. In the Netherworld.
Which, like, I didn't, like, a year or two ago. But having to troubleshoot shit all the goddamn time really changes that quickly.
Father, what is wrong?
Manus2k6 says, I'm on the first book, just ending it. I really like the fighting action 2D.
Yeah,
it's really cool, isn't it?
Ask me anything about myself. I'll prove it. I can answer
the,
any question.
The sliding art could have been very poorly done. Right, like,
Father.
They could have been very lazy with it and not done a whole lot, but they really put the effort in with their animations and, like, especially with the attacks.
I'm so alone.
The combo systems seem to just be,
my own father.
Like, far beyond what I've seen in most beat-em-ups.
The Queen of the Netherworld said?
Even some of the newer, I mean, I guess not newer ones, but like the,
I love the princess,
I guess like older, but also more recent
that
ones.
Said that he was on his way to see Princess Velvet.
You get like, you get like Double Dragon Neon, or you get, say like Castle Crashers or Scott Pilgrim, and their combat systems are... They're fine, right? But they're not nearly this fleshed out. They're not nearly so, like, fluid, I find. Like, they all have that, like, hit, 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 static, hit, right? Like, they all have, like, a really jerky... And, like, as smooth as they are, as quick and, like, chainable as some of their combo moves are... Oh, Manus2k6 is following now. Thank you. Thank you, bud. Welcome. Welcome to the crew. I hope you enjoy your time here. Yeah, like, as good as they are at, like, stringing some of those moves together in say, like, Scott Pilgrim or Double Dragon Neon, they really, like, don't have the same kind of fluidness that this one seems to have. And, like, it still has that, like... choppy, blocky hit feel to it. But I think that's more like the impact and then the slight cooldown afterwards, right? Hey, we picked up a Miracle Fruit C. Granted to those who complete a trial... Oh, wait, no. Fuck,
I opened my inventory by accident. That's what that is. It's been like a week since we played this, and I forgot my controls. Mind you, when we played it, all up until this point, I've been thinking that triangle is going to give me a heavy attack, and it's not. Which is the one thing I will say is kind of disappointing about the combat in this. I keep expecting a fucking heavy attack to come out. And I guess your heavies are like the charge attacks? Like that? But I mean, it's just kind of not the same. I'm really not a big fan of the charge moves. It's one thing in like a game like say Mega Man, where like you're a ranged character the whole time and you've got like the charged Buster Shot, and like charging it like causes your other abilities to do different things, but like charge attacks are why like I didn't like Blanka in Street Fighter, right? And like similar characters in similar games. It's not a playstyle that I like prefer or like feel comfortable with all that much. Something about like the, I don't know, like pushing down and holding up the button, yeah, like that, like to wait for it all to come out, I'm just not a huge fan of it. I much prefer like quick stringable combos that you can just, like, whip out really fast, right? We are dex-based agility fighters on this channel. We like the rushdown characters. Akihiko is king. God, that would be... I would just love for Alice to decide to port Persona 4 Arena to Steam. Everybody go play all the other Atlas games on Steam so that they bring Persona 4 Arena to Steam. I guess not all the other Atlas games, just the Persona ones. Go play Persona 3 and, like, what, did they bring back 2 or whatever? I'm pretty sure... Ooh, churro. I'm pretty sure Persona 3 is where, like, it starts to actually get good. I don't have a whole lot of experience with Persona 3. I pretty much... Like, all of my experience with P3 is through, like, secondary... weird shit. Like I didn't play P3 at all. I've never seen like footage of it or anything, but I played Persona Q, and I played P4U and P4UA, etc., right? So like I'm familiar with it. But, like, I have seen, like, footage and stuff of Persona 2, and that shit is just weird. It's nothing like the rest of Persona. I mean, it kind of is. It's, like, definitely got that, like, Shin Megami Tensei, like, stands kind of thing going on, but... I don't know. We gotta get rid of these bees first. Oh, okay, right. I forgot what some of my abilities are. Right, so he's got the spin. But he can only do the spin on the ground, right? And he's got the drill thing. And that can be done in the air, and you can change direction with it. Not back and forth, but you can go up and down. Oh, fuck you. Alright, I know there's more of those beehives, but I don't want to dig with them yet. I mean, we don't have any food? How is that? How is that a thing? Because there was no, like, village for... Like, I didn't go to the Pooka village to get any. How is that a thing? God damn. Recover 750 health. We don't even have that much. I don't even have that much fucking health, man. What can I mix to get something else? Like, yeah, let's mix that with a Karateer, right? And we get health. Bamzos. Madness2k6 says, I can't to start Persona 4 Golden. Can't wait to start Persona 4 Golden. I played the first Persona on PSP. Oh, interesting. Interesting. What did you think of it? Because that's what, like, I've seen stuff from Persona 2, but I've not seen anything from Persona 1. That's interesting. That's old. He wanted some old-ass shit. I did play P5 when it came out. I pre-ordered that shit. I pre-ordered the special edition for that. I have the, was it Shinjuku Academy, school bag or whatever that it came with? And the nice fancy box. Oh, the box is almost nicer than the bag, I find. Yeah, that was a good game. I really enjoyed Persona 5. It was super stylish. From the menus to the music, everything. Oh, Log Nendo is here. Welcome. Welcome, bud. How are you? Hope all is well today. Hope you're doing good. Log Nendo asks, feeling better today, Boney? I am, a little bit. So, yesterday, I called the stream kind of early, because, like, this weird wave of, like, how do I describe it? It was, like, a heavy, warm discomfort sort of like washed over me, and I just, like, I don't know, like, I just wasn't into it, like it just, like, it sucked me right out of my vibe and it threw me completely off, and I didn't feel good anymore. So I stopped, and then and after, like, I cleaned up, ate a little bit, I just kind of took it easy for the night and, like, dicked with the, like, zipping of the files. The warm discomfort is gone, but, I'm super tired from being up till 3 a.m. last night waiting for that fucking file to unzip. Little bit sleepy, but we're here, and I have confidence that the sick ass action and combos will give me the energy I need to press forward. Thank you for asking. Thank you for your concern, Log Nico. I appreciate that. Thundercloud, summon a cumulonimbus. There we go. Which will generate lightning for a time. Thundercloud, yeah. It's basically, Nami's Thundercloud Tempo from One Piece. We can spend Fozons to upgrade it, and that's exactly what we're gonna do. To make attack go up, and make pee-pee go up. Make big pee-pee go up. We don't get a pee-pee bonus for the next one, huh? That's interesting. We usually get, like, a consistent buff all the way up. Like, the attack will go up, right? Like, plus 6 attack, right? But we still get, like, plus 1 PP, like, as we go up, usually. Strange. Manus2k6 is... Really, yeah, that was some old-type shit. It was very unique-type slots towards novel, though. Like, they knew they were... They knew there was way more to come. This guy says, my medication leaves me with 3 hours to sleep too, so it's been a rough week. Ooh, bud. Ooh. Ooh, it's okay, man. We'll get jackets. and we'll have a club. The I'm tired because I only got 3 hours of sleep club. And it's cool, we'll hang out outside of like convenience stores with our jackets, and we'll I don't know, do people still doo-wop? Right? Do people still like a cappella on the street? Manus2k6 says, how's your PS3 library look like? Listen here, you, about the PS3 library. every time I think about that today, it just makes me want to cry. So my PS3 library, you know what? I can show you my PS3 library. As of right now, let me tab over for a second. As of right now, my PS3 library consists of this. However, this does have, what is it? MGS 1, 2, 3, 4, Peace Walker, and the original Metal Gear and Metal Gear 2. And I think, like, the VR missions. This is the only game I have for the PS3 right now. I do have a list to grab for the emulator. However, right now I'm in the midst of setting up Dolphin, which is the GameCube and Wii emulator. And it's the ROMs for that are giving me a really hard time. The ones that are just like freezing my computer and janking things up. Oh, excuse me. So I'm trying to get all of those installed and unzipped and everything and dealt with, right? I'm trying to get all the GameCube and Wii stuff finished, and then I will deal with the PS3 stuff. Because I actually went through like the whole game list for the PS1 and the GBA and the GameCube and the Wii, and I found all of the games that I wanted. So it's just a matter of getting the last of it loaded on there, and then I can start on the last chunk, which would be the PS2/PS3 stuff. Sky says, I and Stan semi-sleeping in the middle of sidewalks. Yeah. Yeah, we'll pass out halfway through our doo-wops. And then get back up again because we can't be allowed to sleep that long. and it says, I have something with a mod on it. Want some recommended games is all. Oh, okay. Yeah. Yeah, absolutely. If you've got recommended games that you want to see on the channel, by all means, toss them my way. And we can give it a shot. We can see what we can do about it. What am I doing? I'm trying to talk to him. Lugnex said, I ordered a new screen for the GBA, by the way. Oh, excellent! Nice! And a new GBA because the GBA I had stopped working for some reason. Probably the soldering or something. Oh! And this is, I'm dropping the audio amplifier mod because it was such a hard thing to do. Yeah, that could. Yeah, if you're looking to drop anything to save you some time and effort, that's probably something that I guess doesn't really need to be in there, right? I mean, like, don't get me wrong, the GBA has some great like audio on it. Some of the soundtracks for those games were dynamite, but I mean, like, doesn't really need to be louder or fuller or anything like that, does it? I mean, I guess if you're modding and tricking out a GBA to make it better, you might as well go all out, right? But
If you're looking to save time and effort in one place, that might be something you can afford to just leave stock. Man, I'm so sorry that you have to keep, like, ordering parts for this fucking thing. You've been working on that for a while now. Waiting for, like, all your parts to come in, and then they get, like, damaged and shipped to the wrong place, and... I'm so sorry you have to go through all of this. I know how much of a pain in the ass it is when you're, like, in the middle of a project, and, like, there's just one problem after another that keeps popping up. It's like every project I ever do. It's like there's gotta be some problem. And then you solve that problem, and then no, you didn't. You didn't solve that problem at all, actually. Solve it again. And then solve a different problem. Okay, so this guy sells, like, crap, really. Curves 80 HP, and you eat it twice. It's 160. That's not too bad. Hot cross buns. Hot cross buns. Da-da-da. Boy, am I glad I learned how to play hot cross buns on the recorder at school instead of learning how to, you know, like, prepare for an interview. That was a great life skill. Lognega said, also the mod didn't have any good video tutorial. Ooh. Yeah, if you can't see somebody doing it, then that's a little sketchy. So I order from eBay Japan, never again Canada, before they get better. Yeah, I don't know if /1 Canada Post will ever get better with their shit. Please stay,
Opa. A new recipe! Now then,
what do you... Man, can I take churros with me? No, I can't. I could take grilled lamb, though, if I had a lamb. Ooh. Egg on toast, we can make that to take it with us. We can eat it 3 times and it'll recover 250 HP. That is awesome. Oh, we get a bonus for, like, everything? Oh, shit, son! Oh, shit! Do you see this madness? Oh, my God. Okay. Alright, we're gonna hold off. We're gonna hold off till we need it. Right?
Thank you very much.
And we will come back to this ugly little cretin. And we will get him to make us food when we actually need the food. Until then, I have to get fucking bread and eggs from this guy. Bye. Okay, so we have one egg, and we need one bread to counter balance it out. So we need one and one, right? How many of these can we buy? Probably like 8 eggs and... Close to, but probably like 7 eggs and like 8 or 9 buns. But, you know, we'll just go with that. We'll go with that for now. Look at this bullshit. That'll do very well. There is... Ah-ha! I heard it. I heard that fucking thing. Where does this... Wait. Oh, that's the exit to the... Okay. I thought I could go to the Pooka village with it. Depressed. Where do we... Oh, shit, no. That's not... Oh, no, this is not what I wanted to do. Not at all. Fuck. Okay, it's fine. I'm doing fine. Oh man, you know what? I didn't use that fucking thundercloud thing yet, did I? What is this one? Surround yourself with electric shots. Oh yeah, that one sucks. So does that one. Thundercloud, let's try it out. Yeah, that's totally thundercloud tempo. You guys like One Piece? I like One Piece. Oh god, is it gonna... Is it summoning more dudes, or what? Grizzlies. Just coming in out of nowhere. Be real cool if those Mandragora dudes drop Onyones. Or some other type of Mandragora that I could pick up and eat. Or use in a potion. Ah! Woo! What do I have to stuff in my weird furry maw? Okay, you can't eat eggs. But you can... Wait, you can hatch the... I can hatch an egg and turn it into a chicken, right? Yeah. Pomegranate. Oh, cool. Hey, I can eat a pomegranate. Oh, hey. Alright. Let's go fight that big ass plant. Woo! What do we have to throw at it? Yeah, let's get some fire attacks in there, man. Oh, are you kidding? Boo earns. Let's try that again before I get surrounded. That's better. I can attack from this side so it wants to, like, move in. There we go, yeah. Move into the fire. Yeah, that actually really helps a lot. God, and it's not even trying to move away. It's just sitting there eating up flames. And now we throw Volcano out. And why not Toxin as well? Just to add injury to the insult. I think that's pretty insulting, throwing a poison potion at a plant that probably spits poison. Ooh, I could eat the pomegranate, but I'm almost done with the plant, so... Yeah, look at that. Da 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 da. Ba 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 da da da. Final Fantasy victory song. Alright, and I took a whole bunch of damage. That's great. Because that means I can get food. And it won't be like a waste. Ooh. I hear you. I hear your little chittery, clicky, whatever. Where is the rest? There it is. Alright. Come on out and cook for me, you monster. But before you do, hey. There is... I can do stuff with an egg, right? Use it. But also plant seeds, right? Yeah. And now it will come this way and it will eat. No, go this way. My little duckling chicken child. This way, dumbass. Over here where the flowers are. Stupid. No, stupid, go the other way. What a dumb chick. What, you idiot. Is it too far? No, huh? Oh, I'm stupid. You're supposed to drop the seeds, not plant them. Oh, I'm stupid. Hold on. Yeah, you drop them, right? Like, yeah, you're supposed to drop them, not plant them. I'm a fucking moron. Oi, bird. What a dumb bird. I guess I could use Fozons to grow those. I don't really want to, though. I'm more comfortable just leaving them, all things considered. You know what, let's do this and maybe the chick will walk around.
Lord, I am honored. Now then.
While we're getting fed. Omelette time! Woo!
Very well, leave it to me.
Long enough, because I agree with that you learn so much useless things in school.
Yeah, they teach you a lot of dumbass shit, like quadratics, parabolas.
Is there anything else you want to order?
All kinds of shit. I never learned how to fill out my own tax return, but boy am I glad that I know that the mitochondria is the powerhouse of the cell.
Sorry.
Whatever the fuck that means. I get the feeling, though, that, like, the gross incompetency of the education system is going to be put on full blast soon, and, like, it'll result in a huge workover of the education system.
Very well.
At least I would hope so. I would hope that, like, because, like, you imagine, like, people are going to, like, go into the workforce completely unprepared. And then be like, oh shit, I should have learned this. And then hopefully fingers will start being pointed and they'll start cracking down on the fucking teachers and shit.
Sorry for the wait.
Teachers are always striking for more money and they're like, oh, we don't have enough resources and you know our class sizes are too big and it's like that shouldn't stop you from being able to speak the content to the students.
Sorry for the wait.
Right? Like, as long as you have a voice, you can speak the lesson, you can give your lecture, and right? Like, what is this, like, resources that you're so worried about? Like, are the teachers upset because they don't have a textbook that they can go through to learn the subject weeks before they teach their class? That stupid bird, you're gonna turn around, aren't you? Okay, so I'm fairly certain we can, yeah, hunt this chicken now. Oh, man. Yeah, and we got a chicken, and now I can use the chicken with a thing. Right? What does chicken make?
What there is now, then.
What there... Potiphar. It's a Potiphar. Let's leave this restaurant. This fucking place. Clown-ass place. Alright, where are we headed to? This place is... Yeah, it's not all that big, actually. There's a Fozon prism over there. God damn, let's go get it. We should probably go down and get that stuff first, and then work our way up and over. We can do that. We'll just go all the way around. We'll get that room to the left there first. Just clear that out, and then we can go all the way around. You guys are squishy and soft, and fuck you. How about that, huh? Huh? How about it? Screw you guys. Fucking bees, my god. Man, when the hell did bees decide to take up carpentry? That's some bullshit. They should have just stuck to paper mache. Or was that hornets? Battle stage. Oh, I went too far, didn't I? Or did I go just far enough? I don't know. I have no idea where the hell I ended up. You know what? I'm thinking that was the wrong button to hit. And also that I want Thundercloud to go right there. Yeah. Thundercloud tempo! Just like her only offensive move, pretty much. I'm going through again and I'm trying to keep track of like any time Nami does anything like other than that. So far she's used like mirages like once or twice, I think. Yeah, pretty much all she does is like shoot lightning. Which, like, I don't know, I feel like it's kinda like a waste of her weather slash navigation skills. Her quote unquote upgrade post time skip is I don't know. Leaves a little bit to be desired, I think. I mean, like, her abilities just seem like reskinned versions of what she was doing before, kind of thing. Where am I now? I went the wrong ass way. Whole ass wrong ass way. Ooh, I could go back and get more food. I could do it. You don't know that I can't. Hey there, old man. I need eggs. Like at least 3. Probably 4. That seems like a good number of eggs to have. Alright, jackass. It's you and me. I demand that you cook for me. I demand that you make one whole omelet. Do it.
Very well.
Do it, food bitch.
Will that be all?
A pot of feu. Yeah, let's get one of these going. It recovers so much. We don't need it. We don't need it. You want to leave the... Oh, no. I didn't want her to leave, though. I wanted to make more... Egg on toast? Egg on toast.
There, now then.
It is egg on toast. Because those are good, like, early game heal items. I mean, 250 3 times? That's pretty dope. We're at level 15 with a max health of 348, so like, that's gonna be pretty helpful.
Very well.
And I really don't think we need to have that many on us, but what are you gonna do about it?
Thank you.
How are you gonna stop me from carrying so much egg on toast? Logan X says, they teach you stuff you don't often need to when you move out. Yeah. Yeah, a lot of, like, valuable life skills went, like, untaught in school. It's weird, because, like, to get, like, to get the stuff that you need, like, there was some stuff taught, like, I did learn how to do, like, a spreadsheet, and, like, financial stuff, like, how to weigh, like, assets and stuff like that, like, as part of a business class that I took. But, like, the stuff that we learn, like, there was, like, the whole, like, marketing and coming up with a product and all that kind of stuff. But there was a lot of, like the financial stuff, like, learning how to write a check properly. Even though checks were kind of, like, phasing out, even at that time, like, we were still learning how to do it. And, like, that seemed useful, but it was like, why are we learning how to do, how to fill out a check in business class and not in, not in, say, like, a life skills class? I took, it was called Family Studies, but it was basically home ed. And they... There was quite a number of things in there that was, like... Oh, I can't carry any more stuff, huh? There was a number of things in there that was, like, good. Like good life skills. Like, in Family Studies, I learned, like, how to read the tags on your laundry... how to work a sewing machine, how to cook a few basic dishes, and, like, things that, like, got you using different things in the kitchen, too. Different, like, appliances and that kind of thing. So it was a good class, right? Like, we did a small unit on, like, nutrition and, what would you call, like, diet planning, I guess? So, like, we did learn some useful stuff, but it's weirdly tucked away in like, the strangest places. Like, Family Studies is the name they gave to home ec, which is, like, the, I guess, like, the common term for that type of class. And, like, there were a bunch of people that, like, laughed and were like, oh my god, you're taking Family Studies? Like, what are you, a chick? Because, like, that was the stereotype, right? Like, boys take wood shop and metal shop and girls take home ec, for various stereotypical gender-biased reasons, right? So, like, you wouldn't have, like, too many people, like, just opting to take that course because they just assume that it's, like, sewing and, like, you get, like, the baby, like, the fake baby that you have to take care of for a week, that kind of thing. Which, ironically, we didn't have to deal with the baby in my class. There's a parenting class, which was actually, like, the second year class that you, could take after the year one Family Studies. So, like, people missed out on, like, valuable life skills because they just assumed that the class didn't offer anything useful or that they wouldn't need the skills that the class offered. Kind of their own fault, for not, like, opening up, like, their mindscape a little bit more, but also kind of, like, the school's fault, I would say, for being, like, I don't know, it just feels like there should be, like a life skills course where, like, all of that kind of stuff is taught, right? And that's one of the mandatory ones. Like, instead of needing, like,
2 arts credits in order to graduate. You need a you need like 3 life skill credits. But again, that would involve like overhauling the system that's there and actually putting in the work to make the system beneficial for the students that, you know, are the ones that need to benefit from the most. It seems like a lot of the people who like work at and for the schools / the school boards don't seem to actually give a shit about the kids and their education and their futures. They're just kind of more concerned about, like, are the teachers' unions happy? Are they getting paid enough? Can we open a new school and thus, you know, ask for a bigger budget next year, right? Like, they don't care about, like, the quality of the education that's being put out. Very, very few. I still have some of my old yearbooks, and like from 2 different schools, and there's like the big pictures, like the big like class photo, but of all of the teachers and all of the staff, and in any one of those photos of all of the staff, I can count on one hand the number of teachers who like actually gave a shit and connected with the students and, you know, like, actually tried to help you learn because they understood how important it was that you actually learn the material. I had a history teacher in high school. Great, amazing teacher. One of the best I've ever had. And he explained to everybody one day that, like, your education is your own business, right? You have the option as an individual, as a human being, you have the option to just ignore everything that I say and not show up to class and not do the homework and fail your course, right? But when your parents come to me and they go, why did Jimmy fail history? I have to be able to say that I taught the lesson. I have to be able to say that I at least tried to teach the material. So whether you're going to pay attention or not, I'm going to teach it. I'm going to do the lesson, and I hope that you will pay attention and benefit from it for your sake. And it really stuck with me. Like, you know, you got to put in your own, like, as much as the teachers got to put in, like, their side of things, like, you also have to put in your side as a student. You have to try to learn. But it simultaneously pointed out that, like, you know, he was trying, right? Like, he actually was trying. He actually was trying to not only teach the lesson and get the information into the people so that they would retain it, but he was taking the time out of the lesson to explain to us the importance of it and the importance of our choices regarding our education. Which, like, maybe he didn't need to do that. Maybe some people feel that's out of line. You know, it's not his job as a teacher, but I think it is. I think it is his job as a teacher, and it was, like, very fitting of him to point out that information and, you know, like, help us to grasp that sort of thing, right? Lognega says, his teachers don't look happy. Says that sounds like one of the golden teachers. He was. He really was. He was fantastic. He took, a deep interest in, like the students, like, what they were doing, right? Like if he caught you doing something on the computer that, like, wasn't for class, he'd be like, what are you doing? What are you checking out here? What's this for?
explain it to me. Explain what it is and what you're into and why you're into it, right? And he really wanted to, like, know more, like, about you and about, like, what made you a person and, like, just tried to connect with you, right? And that's something that you just didn't get from a lot of the other teachers. I remember running into his wife, just, like, in the store, several years later. I said, you're this teacher's wife, right? Because she also taught at the school as well. And, I was like, I have to say, like, he was, like, one of the best teachers I've ever had. I'm so thankful for everything he did for me. Please, whenever you see him, tell him thank you so much for me, and I hope he's doing well, etc., right? Great, great guy. Great teacher. Those who do business on King's Main Street shall be fined. Those who do business without express permission from the king shall also be fined. Those who do not pay the tax shall be executed by hanging. Those who complain of high taxes shall be subject to flogging and the stocks. Those who discriminate against Magi shall be subject to the stocks. Those who cause bloodshed shall be executed on the spot or by hanging. King Edmund was initially welcomed by the people as the heir to the legacy of the wise previous ruler. When he began imposing harsh laws and taxation policies, however, public favor turned foul. Thus concludes the Law of Titania. Lognega said, I got to learn later that my teacher wasn't the best. I don't remember her so good, but I probably turned a blind ear to her a lot since I didn't get it. So even my parents apparently caught on to her for being rude since I had learning needs and threatening to pull my little brother out of her class when my brother got her as a teacher. Oh, shit. Oh, so they were well aware of her bullshit and were like, nah. Nah, fam. Oh, man. I had a teacher, an English teacher, the one year, who was just super rude, just like the most ignorant lady ever. I was venting about her to my mom after school the one day, and my mom was like, "She did what? No, she can't be, like, talking to you like that. That's bullshit." So she started, like, sending letters and trying to call the school and, like, get her on the phone so that she could talk to her. And the fucking bitch kept, like, dodging my mom's phone calls and refused to, like, talk to her about it. And I'd go in and I'd be like, you know my mom's trying to, like, speak to you, right? She's trying to get a hold of you on the phone. You need to answer the phone when she calls. She'd be like, oh, well, if she calls while I'm in the middle of a lesson, and I'd be like, you know, I'm pretty sure your class will wait. I'm pretty sure your class will wait while you take a phone call, like you do every time you get a phone call in the middle of class. Hey, I'm an idiot. Don't try and pull that I'm busy bullshit. Like, oh, excuse me, everybody. I'll just be a second whenever the fucking thing rings. Bitch. Fucking hated that woman. Ooh, vampiric ring. Yeah, let's get one of these. Let's get the shit out of that. Oh, wait, I have to actually pick it up before I can equip it. That's how video games work. I do not have running speed 10% of. Did I not equip that? Huh. Just don't. Alright, well. Fine then. Let's get rid of this. And this. And this. Oh, what a bunch of crap to get rid of. Boom, 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 boom. Boom, boom. Boom. Let me get rid of it. Wow. I don't know if that's picking up on the microphone or not, but I'm gonna
close my windows.
Sorry, the sirens are real loud out there, and I don't know if that's catching. Woo! Fucking. Ugh.
Teacher who knows when she did something dumb, but she don't want to own up to it. That's exactly right. Yeah.
Yeah, she knew she got got. She knew she was up against a wall. Was like, no, I'm not gonna deal with it. I was like, that's fine. That's fine. You don't wanna be an adult and have a conversation about your behavior with your students. That's fine. I'm gonna make a special request for something to do for the last day of class, for like the end of the semester, and then not show up. We were doing a poetry unit to close out the year, and I specifically asked, I was like, hey, can we go through and do an analysis of The Highwaymen? Because it's such a classic. And she's like, ooh, yeah, we'll do that on this day, yeah. That sounds fantastic, because I didn't have a plan for that yet. Well, yeah. And I was like, haha, ha, you dumb bitch. The Highwayman is like a 10-15 minute poem. You fool! And then proceeded to do the thing that all students do and just didn't show up in the last day, so. Ha 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 ha! Fuck her. God, this thing is ugly. What did they call? Is this the Chimera? This thing is gross looking. It looks like a witch. But like, it's also got that weird alien mouth inside its own mouth thing going on. You know, where like it pukes its own mouth up? Ah, alien. The weird ass fucking creature they are, the xenomorphs. Damn xenomorphs and their gears. Alright, do we eat egg on? No, let's not waste the egg on the toast. Let's eat a bunch of pomegranates. Pomegranies. And some rotten mulberries. Hey, ha, 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 yeah. It's okay. If I can get like one at a time, that might be good. Oh, I got the berries. Or I got a berry. But I did not get the pomegranates. Ooh, get him. Get him, thundercloud bullshit. Skin is like decaying and falling apart. What a gross looking monster. Ooh. Yeah, do that buzzsaw thing. Like, again, it's really cool. I like when you do that. I also like when I get to eat the pomegranate and the health go up. What is, oh, that one is my fucking vampire ring. That's real cool. I guess even if I do like really low damage on an enemy, I'll still gain like a minimum of one health back, right? That's pretty cool.
Lognega says, I kickstarted another game today, by the way. Oh, cool. Says, it's a puzzle platformer as a bird. Ooh, interesting.
A bird as a main playable character is an interesting choice for a platformer, because flight kind of makes platforming just
like, meaningless, right? Like, it's, like, it just, like, totally changes slash shits all over the game. It's like, if you gave Mega Man the ability to fly, like, where would the difficulty be, right? That being said, like, ooh, that sounds really cool. And even though I am awful at puzzles... Oh, there's two of them, and it got me right away. Oh, shit. Alright, well, we'll come back to that one. Even though I am terrible at puzzles, I do appreciate a good puzzle. I do like them. I like to do a puzzle, even if I can't do a puzzle. Hey, ha, ha, kya! Oh man, we got a whole bunch of foes on. Upgrade our shit. Yeah, look at that. Takes 205 to upgrade the Cypher. But it would take 80 to upgrade the Thundercloud. Lightning frequency goes up too. Hey, look at that. How much does it take to upgrade again? 140? Eh. What about Spiral Claw? No. Assault High? Increase damage dealt against foes according to the number in a chain. Oh, hey, yeah, that's... Yeah, that's a good one to get. And damage go up. Okay, let's see... We need to go all the way down here, right? Charm? 20% discount on shop items. Ba-boom! And the next one is... Improve grade increase amount during alchemy by 30%. I'm not too worried about that one. These two, however, would be good to get next. Slip past foes by dodging when HP is 30% or lower. Increase HP recovery speed by 20%. You'll start going down these two, I guess. Okay. Get back in the Oh, no! Oh, I got jacked up right away. I guess I have to do that again, don't I? Okay, we'll do it once now before we go in, and then we won't have to do it again. Like, again. Just the one again. Okay. You have acquired Charm. If only it were that simple. Alright, now surely I will be strong enough to beat the frogs. Did he poison me? No, he tried to. I can see him, like, just dripping with it. Bubbling and slipping off of him. Get them, Lightning Cloud. Do it. God damn it. There's a lot of frogs, Jesus Christ. Oh man, if you jump and cast the cloud, it starts really high. And then just... comes down, I guess. Yeah! Cool guard pose. They've sucked up all the Pokemon. Excellent. What did I get? Ooh! Toxin. We already know how to make that, but cool. And free materials are always great. Oh. I don't see any little dudes in the ground. Should we go towards the boss? Yeah. Let's go towards the boss and then come back towards the other guy. And then we'll fight those chimera dudes. I guess I should try to save up my PP. Hold on. The Thundercloud costs PP. Yeah, okay, so I should try and save it up until we get there. Because we want a full PP when we see those gross monsters. But the other moves, like Spiral Claw and Whirling Blade, yeah, those are POW. So I don't have to worry about those. Oh no, Poisaroni! Do I have an antidote? No, I could make one. Seems like a waste, though. Yeah, especially since it just wore off. The Poisaroni. What can I eat? I don't want to eat any of the egg on toasts, because I'll probably need them. Mind you... you know, let's have the tonic. I don't want to, like, waste any of the ingredient foods now, either, because, like... we need to make all of the food on the menu again. These guys are actually a little bit tougher than I thought they would be. This definitely seems like it's got that classic beat-em-up issue where, like, you've got to go through as far as you can, and then when you hit the wall in your progress, you go back to the beginning of the level you're currently on, or the one before it, and you just do it again for extra experience. Scout Pilgrim is kind of bad for that in some places, and Double Dragon Neon is really bad for that as well. I'm really interested to see how that is in, Phantom Breaker Battlegrounds. Which we have yet to check out. I've yet to check that out at all. Like I haven't played it yet myself. All I know is from what I've seen about it on the Steam store. See, every time I went to go look for Scott Pilgrim, it was like, you want this. You want Phantom Breaker. And I'm like, no. No, I don't. Wait, maybe I do. All they had to say was, like, anime waifu beat him up, and I was like, oh, yeah, alright, well, yeah. Yeah, that's fine. This is actually okay. Woo! Alright, where is the exit? Let's go back to the rest point. Doo-doo-doo. A-boop-a-doo. Oh, yeah, I didn't plant a rose mill, did I? Or a mulberry, whatever. Shut up. What happens if I plant the rose mill? Does that one... No, it doesn't do shit. Okay. Yeah, I'll plant a mulberry seed. And that will cause all of the Fozons to flow into my sword. What a cool guy. I have all of the mulberries.
Alright, you horrid beast. Oh! Oh, speaking of food...
Mine is ready, so I'm going to pause. I'm going to tab over, I'm going to go get my food, and I will be back in just a second. Don't go nowhere.
Okay, I'm back. Here I am. While I eat, I am BoneSkore. Isn't this a treat? Okay.
Maury's Touring Restaurant. No building, no problem. There is much green here. It shall be quite a pleasant meal today. Now then, what do you want to order?
No building? No problem. They can't shut you down for health code violations if there's no place for the violations to occur.
As you wish.
Oh, man. I'm super glad that dinner happened right when we had to come back to the restaurant, because, like, boy, was I getting hungry.
Very well.
Bring me my dessert. My muggle confit, and my churro, and my yogurt mousse. I mean, I don't even have 500 HP. But, like, look at that experience. You know, I'm gonna get it, like, once just for the experience. Fuck it. Fuck it, why not, right? We need the experience for this thing we're about to do. Oh, man, look at that. We almost have a full level. That's not quite enough for another level, but we can do it anyways.
As you wish.
And then we can make a level happen with, like, the fruit in our inventory.
Will that be all?
Oh, it did go up. Huh, okay.
I await your first.
Goodbye, gross weird guy. Alright, so we need to go back. This way? Wait. And then we will. Yeah, okay, and then we'll head to the left there. Wonderful. Brilliant! More froggos! Oh no! Oh, they're soft and squishy, these ones. It's not like a fight like last time. I guess this isn't a. Yeah. The rectangular areas don't seem to be, like, battle areas too often. I guess they want you to have that, that round space to, like, run around and get distance on. Hold up, where? Oh, you have to get through there to get that other room. Okay. Alright. I have 100 thingums. Plasma Circle? No. Whirling Blades? No. Ooh. I need 12 Fozons. God, if I had a Rosemill Seed, probably wouldn't do me any good. Spiral Claw. Yeah, fuck it, why not? Why the hell not? Knockback ability goes up, huh? And we could probably grab another ability as well. Which one do we want to grab? Power Supply? That makes power upon defeating a foe. That takes 7. We probably spend... Yeah. We can spend 2 to get increased HP recovery. That sounds like a good boost to me. Then we can go for... What's this here? No. We don't have enough for that. After eating food, increases damage of next attack by 30%. Oh, hell yeah. That also seems like a good thing that we would want in an upcoming boss fight. I mean, these challenge fights are almost as tough, if not tougher, than the boss fights. Okay, don't get... Oh, man. Yeah, you don't want to get, like, flanked by them. So let's start... with some good old-fashioned... potion... attacks. Toxin. Boom! Just, yeah. Just try to go right through them. Excellent, yeah. Exactly what I wanted. Oh boy. Woo! Wrong button. Oh man, please stop following me. Oh shit. Please stop, please stop. Oh, there's items back there that would actually be super useful. Not the mulberry seed, not the grape seed. Volcano would be super useful. Uh-oh. Woo! Heal tonic. Fucking just do it. God, that was supposed to heal 900 health? Holy shit. What a waste. Oh, man. Oh, fuck, these guys are tough. They don't quit. Overload increases damage dealt, huh? How long does that last? 18 seconds? And that's just all damage, huh? Okay, I have an idea. Two. We're gonna mix the two, and the two, and the two, and the three, and the four. Yeah. Yeah, we're doing it. We're gonna make a level 6 Whirlwind. Because why the fuck not? Oh, okay, and that Shine Potion. You know what? That can be turned into... a Poisaroni. And... that's not too bad, actually. Fire Spirits. If I add one Havernisto to that, we can get a Volcano. The Fire Spirits might actually be better, all things considered, though. Okay, I need to get some more distance. Just a little bit of distance would be great. Like, just enough distance to get, like, one small heal in would be really cool. Okay. Oh, he's gonna attack me. Yep. Okay. Now is the time to do the thing. Julie, do the thing. Fire spirits. Excellent. I've kinda gotta get another heal in me. Egg on toast. Okay, and then more potions. Yeah, I knew they'd run right into it. Aha, okay. Now we're cooking. Fuck yeah. I love when the whirlwind just picks them up and juggles them like that. You are just a big, dumb chimera caught in the whirlwind. Oh man. Wow. Get through and can I throw anything? Oh, I don't have anything else to throw. Alright, now is a good time to heal with more egg on toast. Haha! Come on, oh, we're almost there. We're so close. Come on. Oh, we can do it. I know we can do this. Fuck yeah. All right. Fucking bangarang. All right. That was fantastic. Man, I kind of actually thought that we were going to have a tough time with that and that I'd have to, like, come back and grind for it or whatever. That was great. You've acquired Spiral Fall. What does it do? High-speed downward drill attack while falling from the air. Oh, that's cool. Hmm. Okay. Well, we'll have to check that out in the next fight, then. Spend 35 Phozons to upgrade it? Eh, why not? We'll get an attack boost. And then hopefully it'll only take, like, what? So, oh, it'll take 80, huh? Oh, so close. I'm sure we'll find a way to acquire 13 more Phozons. Can't carry any more mulberry seeds or onions. Onione. Hey. I like that there's just treasure here and not treasure and. You know when there's like treasure and an enemy or treasure and some bullshit. Hey. I got fucking grapes out of the tree. That was cool. That was super cool. Alright. So I guess we're just headed straight to the boss now. We're at full health, so we don't need to go back to that traveling monstrosity. And go, Pooka! I want to actually equip that ring that we just got. What do I want to take off, though? Recovery rate of POW gauge. 5% chance to nullify damage. Eating speed and HP recovery speed. Let's take this off. In favor of the gourmet ring. Because being able to eat faster is a really good power. Not just in video games, but in real life, too. I wish I could eat faster without, like, choking myself all the time. You sure you want to face this dude? This fucking Broheim?
I used to run along this same path to meet her back then. And now this. There he is.
Are you just, like, upset about your form, your present state?
Ah! You're late. I have been waiting for you. Who are you? Are you saying that you knew I was going to return to Titania? You must be the one who turned me into this.
Hmm.
What is it that you want? I cannot simply tell you.
That's rather clever. Sword and mind are sharp. Using the same character model so they don't have to, like, create a new
can you do that
person
now?
Or whatever. Oh!
It's me, Prince.
And it was her all along.
What's wrong? Your beloved is right here.
Oh no!
Why not recite a poem to me? Should I rock you to sleep?
Princess!
Oh, was you playing him the whole time?
I suppose being madly in love clouds one's judgment.
Aw, man.
But when you awaken, you realize that life is cruel.
Oh,
no, it's a lie.
Oh, she found out something, and now she's all upset.
Naive morons like yourself make me furious. You should be killed.
She found out something about his royal whatever.
Shut up! You cannot be her.
How about you guys have an actual conversation instead of throwing poetry and insults at each other? Oh, Velvet's imposter, so it may not actually be Velvet. Oh, do you think it's possibly, like, Mercedes in disguise? I guess that's a possibility, yeah? Oh man, that, like, fire tornado move is really cool. I really like her class type. Ever since I saw Hunter Hunter, the idea of, like, the chain dancer has been, like, just a really cool idea. I know there's a class in D&D like that. I think it's one of the wizard classes, subclasses. It's the, it's like the sword dancer or whatever. Or the sword singer or whatever. It's like a like an elven wizard specific class. But they like sing and they dance while they fight. And like one of the options is to spec into wielding chains. And I thought that was like just like the coolest fucking thing. Cause like you're basically doing poi on the battlefield. Oh man, we didn't check out, what's it called? Spiral Fall! Oh, that's- oh man, that looked like it might have actually been good if it had landed. Whoa, I am on fire. Del un fuego. Right? Alright, what do we want to eat? Egg on toast. How could you eat anything besides it? Actually, let's eat the grapes. And a mulberry. Two. Is that it? Oh man. I wasn't expecting such a big explosion, like, focused on her. Really? I have, like, nothing to throw at her, huh? I would have to make potions.
We're doing pretty good, though. She's only got, like, one health bar left. The imposter bitch. Why don't we try out this right now? Right here. Right now. In the heat of battle. Just upgrade it for no reason. And then see if I can't. Oh, yeah, it works. That wasn't like as clean a landing as I wanted, but it's fine. Okay. I need to heal. Yes, I do. I'm gonna eat some stuff and it's not gonna be enough. One, two, three. That was not nearly enough. I'm kind of remiss to spend, like, a lot of heals right now, though. Eat. I want to eat it, like, just once. There we go. Two, three, one, two. Three, go! Oh. You're almost done. Just lay down and accept it. Just, no, don't heal! Don't use a healing potion, you bitch! That's, no, come on. Yeah! I win. Suck up all the foes off. Oh, come on! I didn't get to absorb the Fozons. That's bullshit.
Such a terrible sword.
What? Yeah, who are you?
You're obviously not Velvet. I am Ingwe.
Ingwe?
I am Velvet's twin brother.
Oh, shit!
A brother?
That's a lie.
Yes, I suppose I can see.
No, that's totally a lie.
Why did you curse me? Why was I in the Netherworld? Answer me!
The Netherworld? I know nothing about that.
Yeah, see, he's
but
full of
yes,
shit.
Twas I who cast the Pooka's curse on you. How could I give my darling sister to you? There's no way to resume your human
But Velvet
shape.
Is...
Forget about Velvet.
Like Odin's
you two cannot be together.
Illegitimate daughter, you. Right? Kill so that would mean wish. That this guy would also be Odin's illegitimate child. But Odin made no mention of this kid Velvet when approaches. Telling us the story
what
of what happened
Cornelius?
With like him and Velvet. And Velvet never mentioned her,
her
brother
like
either, right? In all of her like
I won't forget this, Ingwe.
Anger and hatred towards Odin and like what he did, like
Ingwe! What happened?
Oh, she
You're
does
hurt.
Know him, huh?
Tis nothing, worry not.
Okay.
What are you doing hiding from me?
So I guess Odin was probably just trying to conceal
Ingwe.
Another you illegitimate talk. Child by not bringing
You've
him
been
up.
Meeting with that oaf in secret.
He is no oaf. Cornelius is a gentleman.
Or maybe they just lately, don't know? Maybe neither of them are aware
He's
of her origins yet?
Man.
I don't know.
I'm sure he has a reason. Give me back my chain. Please don't take it without asking.
I don't think you should be flailing it around. Just learn to live peacefully and quietly.
You know very
well
that
yes.
we will never live in peace.
When somebody comes in and tries to pick a fight,
obligations.
You should just let them fight. Like without resistance. Just take the beating. That's great advice. An entry has been added to the text archive, Royal Survivors. North of Titania, in the woods close to the border of the Demon Lord's Kingdom, there is an old and decrepit castle. However, you must not draw near it. It fucking stinks. Somebody shat in it once and never cleaned it up.
was once a villa for the sickly wife of the demon lord, but the prince and the princess of Valentine have been recently sighted there, probably squatting in the shithouse. They say the young survivors were spared by the Aesir. Because even they were like, man, this is, we can't kill these people, this is fucked up. War is a dark and disturbing thing, man, what are we doing here? But everyone knows Valentinians are black gods who use their fearsome magic to invade our land. Vicious Magi like them only know to bite the hand that feeds them. I hear Prince Cornelius is seen there often. He is a gentle young man. I hope he does not fall prey to their wiles. I don't quite know what this is saying. I don't really like the tone of it, though. This note contains rumors circulating in Titania. Valentine is still considered dangerous by many, and even the survivors are not spared public suspicion. It seems like there's a little bit more hate towards just this neighboring kingdom than you would initially think. What is that called? Streak Slash? Ooh. Slash ahead with an instant step in. Oh, cool. Oh, I wish I'd saved my Fozons for that. Oh, that's gonna be awesome. Do you want to save the game? Yeah. Yeah, I guess. I guess I'll save it. Oh, fuck. Alright, let's do this. Pooka Prince, Chapter 4, Act 1. Are you able to, like... Yeah, so you just sort of wander through here. I guess this is, like, the castle before a mission, and then... Man, is the village, like, on the map somewhere? Oh, hey, this is where I am. This is where I am. So we're actually about... Oh no, yeah, Prelude. The Demon Lord's army Aesir begins their invasion of the Fairyland to gain control of the cauldron. Meanwhile, the prince finally returns to Titania, but another Cornelius appears in the throne room. Huh. So while the Valkyries were attacking the forest, Cornelius was also wandering around out there somewhere looking for Velvet. Huh. Interesting. I am, like, really, really feeling the exhaustion, though. I don't know that I'll be able to focus through, like, a whole nother dungeon like that today. So, thankfully, we just saved. So, I'm going to... Boop. And this is probably where we're going to call it for today. I apologize again, guys, for it being another short stream today. I'm super sorry about that. I didn't expect the fucking zip thing to take so long last night. And hopefully I won't end up in that situation again where it just decides that it's going to go fucking forever, right? Yeah, I'm gonna update that program before I go using it again. But, yeah. We'll come back to this tomorrow, and I will hopefully be more rested and more energetic, and we'll be able to go through more chapters. It'll be a good time. We'll have a good time with it tomorrow. We'll make up for the last 2 days of the bad feels. In the meantime, we'll just keep this simple and short. I will thank everybody who came to hang out today in the chat or on the archive. Thank you, Mad Priest, to you guys, and hope you enjoyed what there was today and what we will do in the future. I look forward to seeing you all here again, and until I do, stay inside and stay safe, stay hygienic and clean. And your old pal BoneSkore here of the Bone Pit. We'll catch you all later.
So have yourselves a good state of existence. And I will see you next time. Okay, guys? Once again, sorry about the short time today. We'll make it up tomorrow, okay? Bye-bye!